Hi, my name's Andy Leventis, and I'm Supervisory Economist with the Federal Housing Finance Agency. I'd like to tell you a little bit about the FHFA House Price Index report for the first quarter of 2016. For the U.S. as a whole, home price appreciation was extremely robust in the first quarter. Prices grew 1.3% between the fourth quarter of last year and the first quarter of this year. First quarter house prices were roughly 5.7% above where they were the same period 1 year ago, and this was the fourth consecutive year in which prices grew by more than 5%. Home prices were able to push higher in part because of extremely low housing inventories and falling mortgage rates. Interest rates for 30-year fixed rate mortgages were approaching 4% at the end of 2015, but fell to less than 3.7% in the first quarter. Improving employment in some areas and strong buyer confidence also boosted home prices. Consistent with what we saw in the last HPI release, the strongest housing markets remained mostly out west. Over the last four quarters, prices rose by 9% or more in Washington, Oregon, Nevada, and Colorado. Florida, which saw prices rise over 11%, was the only non-western state amongst the top five highest appreciating states. The metropolitan areas with the most robust housing markets were in Florida, Oregon, and Washington. In Florida, the metropolitan areas of West Palm Beach, North Port Sarasota, and Cape Coral all saw prices grow by more than 12%. On the other side of the country, the Seattle area had four-quarter price appreciation of well above 15%, while Portland area prices grew by in excess of 13%. The weakest housing markets in the country were generally on the East Coast. Connecticut and Vermont, for instance, had four-quarter price appreciation of less than 1%. A few oil-rich states also were among the poorest performers. Oklahoma, Alaska, and Wyoming, for instance, all saw prices grow between 1 and 2%. Over the latest quarter, there was some evidence of a slowdown in price appreciation. 12 states and Washington, D.C. saw prices decline in the quarter, the most areas to see price depreciation since the fourth quarter of 2013. As we look ahead, it's not clear whether this is the beginning of a tempering of home price appreciation rates. This is just a single quarter. Still, as we've noted in the past, the vast price appreciation of the last few years significantly impacted home affordability, and without large gains in household income, the types of large and widespread home price growth we've been seeing over the last few years will be difficult to sustain. For FHFA, this is Andy Leventis.